legs are, but we're getting there.
Try this.
I don't know. It's heavier.
It's much sharper though.
It's awesome.
I'm just wondering because that's so damn hard.
That ain't gonna work.
How much more do we need, Lord?
How much more?
Yeah, you guys get ready to take a spot. Take a break, man.
We made a lot of smoke, but no fire. I think that it would have been nice if we had fire. We're not going to catch fish unless we have fire to cook it. And I think that if we had fire, we could have spent a lot of time sitting around the bonfire at night, maybe singing songs. We have a ukulele, you know, and that didn't happen, and I wish it did.
We got a float.
I'm definitely catching a fish today. Sea bass or salmon or whatever the hell we can get out of this ocean.
Fish is a priority right now. Fish is very much a priority. Now that we have the fire, we need something to cook in it.
Hey, where's Super Paul? This is so Super Paul. Look at this. I got the man's grip.
Where's your hook?
We're working. It's right underneath. The sinker is a free-floating float. And all I do is I take line out, cast, boom. Got Super Paul. And then I reel in the big one.
Not too shabby. Been fishing all day today and still nothing. I don't even get a nibble. So that's, you know, really dissatisfying. Fishing is horrible. That saying, there's a lot of fish in the sea, not this sea. They apparently didn't grow up in Paluatiga because there is nothing to be caught out there. He overestimates himself sometimes, and we were kind of thinking that he wasn't going to catch anything. When you snorkel down there, there's nothing to even stab at. We have a good pole. I have my Super Pole, which is, you know, it works in a Gilligan's Island sort of sense.
We got some maggots, we got the Super Pole 2000, and we got the persistence of Dirk and me. You can't lose.
Feeling good today, buddy.
We gotta come back with fish tonight.
If somebody gets a fish in the spear, I'll be seriously impressed, man.
Oh, I. Rich says he could do it.
Well, Rich is confident, man. I appreciate it.
If I was a little fish and I saw Rich swimming at me, I wouldn't be sticking around long. Big gay man with a spear coming right at me.
Sean, you and Dirk went out, tried to catch fish for a few days.
Went out again today.
Do you feel, even though you're putting forth the effort, do you feel a bit threatened by the fact that when it comes to assessing people's worth, Richard did deliver and you haven't been able to catch any fish? Or is that just one aspect?
No, I don't think so right now at this point. But I think that Richard catching fish is great for the group. And I'm pretty comfortable in my position. I'm somewhat entertaining sometimes. I make people laugh. I'm keeping people healthy. And so I'm comfortable with my role. Fishless or fish worthy. Voting for Stacy, nothing personal, just say that we need as much athleticism and brute force in this competition. I love her to death, and this is no reflection on the type of person she is. I had this vision, and I thought I'd build myself a bowling alley right about here. That's what I'm doing here, slaving away. What I think I might do is I might take some of those coconuts over there that are lined up like that. I might take that bamboo over there and make like a little shelf where you can have the extra balls hanging out up there. I just think that we need to do something simple but extravagant, like one thing that we all work on, you know, similar to like the Rose Bowl.
I just wish people would, you know, see things my way in terms that I think that what they want is something really spectacular. And I think that we could work through the night and build something really spectacular that would ensure us getting that crate.
Kelly thinks that failure to catch fish is failure to try. You know, I think she's equating those two, which is not true.
Right now, we could be working, driving through rush hour traffic,
yep,
fighting bills and trying to get dates. Instead, we're just chilling on the South China Sea.
The fish are not biting hooks out here for some reason. Either we got the wrong bait, we're going at the wrong time. It's expected to get on each other's nerves. Maybe everyone's on my nerves too, but I just don't really act on it. I just want to be happy. Have a nice life here, and that's it.
Hey,
right on the coconut.
That wasn't too bad.
turns out that I'm pretty good with the blowgun, and I never shot a blowgun before in my life.
Dead on. Good.
Oh yeah, it's always in the back of my mind whether or not anyone's gonna vote against me. You know, I don't have a vote against me yet, and now we're losing numbers, so I'm sure one's coming, just like the other people don't have a vote against them. One's coming in their direction too. I suspect it might be Rudy. That's how I would probably cast my vote at this point.
I'm ready.
Sean, your role here.
Very nebulous. I don't know what I'm doing here. So after how long have we been here? 15, 16 days. I still haven't found my niche. I'm just here to have fun. I'll take it as far as I can go. So you can throw me kicking and screaming off this island. I'll take it.
This is the first time I'm voting for Rudy, only because there's probably an athletic competition coming up that we're going to have to win. And that's the only reason I would cast a vote against him. He's a phenomenal person.
You have all night. As you can see, right here, we have two beds.
Oh my God.
So we are definitely staying here tonight?
You are here all night.
Jenna, how styling are we?
Making out, I think, first base, second base up the shirt, third base.
Okay,
out.
Okay.
But I often give a bad first impression sometimes.
You never heard of bases like that?
I always just knew what the home run was. I'm all about the goal.
Round
it's
and home.
Goal-oriented.
Sliding into home plate.
Okay.
They wanted it to be more romantic than it was ever going to be, but, you know, from either end of us. But we really had an exceptional time, and we tied one on, you know, finished the bottles of wine, and we ate like kings and queens, and it was fantastic. And we told Pagan the unfortunate news that they had 5 minutes to pack their things, get their luxury item, and choose three items, which we decided were the wool blanket that they have, the mosquito netting, so we could sleep under the mosquito netting, and the cooking pot.
We were given a luxury dinner, but we had to decide a new name,
which
we had to paint a new flag, and we had to pick a location. She liked our camp a lot.
You guys will love it. Sean left an orgy opportunity.
Yeah, no, I left a two-on-one opportunity. Two girls.
How come you left it?
I was scared out of my mind.
Aside from the physical, who you want to hang out with, who you like being around, how big a factor is that now going to play in who you vote for?
Well, for me, it's still a very big factor. I think there's a lot of room in a group of 10 to not think ultra-strategically just yet. In talking to my tribe and talking to their tribe as the ambassador, I think that most people were very concerned about alliances, just having a Taggi versus Pagan internal bloodbath, you know, and it's, yeah, it's a good word. But you know, I don't think that's going to occur. I am not really employing any strategy. I'm going voting for Colleen today. I love her. She's cute, adorable, and nice to look at and fun to have around, but she's the first in a long list of alphabetical order. And she won't get another vote from me unless she pisses me off or something. But it's her turn today, being the first. Alphabetical order.
Today is like day 22. We had a boat last night, which is always pretty beat. Always puts us in a pretty somber mood. Last night was a very strange boat. You know, the bloodbath has begun. You know, people have started taking it a different way because there's really no good reason other than strategy to vote Gretchen off. I think that my former team, Taggi, probably formed an alliance against what they perceived as her, as their strongest member of Pagan, which was Gretchen.
You know, if it has anything to do with something from home, I'd like Jenna to win it.
Thank you, Sean. I hope it's my pictures.
They might have our family send a care package or something, everybody, and they'll just give you the care package.
Sean, I think you think it's James.
My sister. Yeah, as we call that, the poo bomb.
You think he'll notice?
We miss you, Sean. Come home soon, but not too soon.
I definitely see Greg differently now after seeing his video and attaching a little bit of a family with him. At least we know he's not the only screwball in his family. Maybe there's a genetic trait over there.
I'm keeping with my strategy of alphabetical order. I'm voting for Greg tonight because it would have been Jervis's turn, but he won immunity, so I had to skip him. Next person in order is Greg. I don't think this vote's gonna mean very much. Rich is definitely in this very good strategic position for himself, I think. He's worked hard. Well, not that hard. He just happens to be good at spearfishing, actually. He doesn't do much else. Yeah.
He sure don't do a damn thing around here except fish. That's
but he's a good sport. I mean, you know, we call him all kinds of names. He's in an ideal position because I think he's the epicenter of the power right now. He's bringing in the fish. I love Rich. I really do. He's been a great asset to this camp, but he is a little immature in his motives at times.
You're going to be so damn full of protein after this meal, you won't know what to do with yourself.
This is funny.
I am.
This man.
He's very protective about spearing fish. And he brings up every island council. I'm catching fish. Don't vote me off. It's an insecurity aspect to him.
Oh, wow.
I love getting mail, and there was a log hanging above our mailbox. It looked an awful lot like part of the tree. But when I took it down, there was a sign on there, a little nursery rhyme says,
if you can make like a monkey,
then you'll be home free.
If you want a barbecue for lunch,
then go climb a tree.
Somebody's eating a barbecue.
That sounds like fish kebab.
I'm sure the game is anything but simple. Just like, just pick a rope and run.
Happy birthday, Rich.
Thanks, Suzuki.
Rich's birthday is today, and it's his 39th birthday, and he celebrated immediately by taking off all of his clothes and celebrating in his birthday suit. Which you never get used to seeing Richard naked.
I know the only way I'm going to stay is to win the challenges, so that's the only thing I'm worried about. That's the only thing I'm focusing on is winning the challenges.
I think it's a fair system. I think you're a perfect example. I'm glad I decided to not go back for the alphabetical order after you win immunity because it gives the contestant an out to avoid my vote.
I think it adds a new dimension to the game of me going alphabetically. I'm going in alphabetical order. Jenna is next. It would make me happy if Jervis does not win immunity this time because I had to skip him last time. You know, I skipped him in the order. And maybe Jenna will win it and get out of the order.
I know it's nice that if you win immunity, you get skipped, and then you never get in the rotation. Like,
oh, you're out of the rotation?
Jerv's out of the rotation.
Oh, so I'm next.
Yeah.
Sean.
Yes.
I gotta ask you about the alphabet thing.
The alphabet.
Give me the rationale so I'm absolutely clear on it.
Okay, the rationale is manifold. First of all, gives me an order that I can follow pretty easily. That's always nice. And it is strategic. If you look at the order, the actual alphabet, a lot of the Pagan people in the beginning, a lot of the Tagi people in the end. This tortures me every 3 days. I hate it.
I don't know. That or he doesn't have enough balls to make a decision.
I don't have a malicious bone in my body. And I think casting a vote makes me feel malicious. If I want to avoid it, I want to avoid it.
But you came into this knowing you were going to have to do this. Me, I've changed my vote like 3 times within the last 2 hours.
And now it's me, right?
No.
Continuing my alphabetic strategy. Jenna, you know I love you. No offense to this. I hope you don't get voted off. I don't think you might have one vote or two votes or something like that, but nothing major, I don't think. I hope. No, I'm not 100% sure. If there is an alliance, they are just voting in block, you know, but I don't know if there is one. I haven't been asked to partake in one or anything yet. Whatever vote I was going to go, they were going to copy. If I knew that, I would certainly have abandoned the strategy earlier.
Everybody yelled at me for doing this alphabet. I thought I was being fair, but actually, I think I was targeting people. And also, if they weren't being targeted, I was going to be targeted because who the hell wants me voting for them, you know? If I kept voting, either I was going to be out or I would keep getting other people's feelings hurt.
It just felt a little scummy to me at the time. But after last night where the remaining tribe members of both parties said, you know, we really don't care. It's just a game. Every single one of them has tried to form a strategy with me personally.
I got to revisit the alphabet voting system because it had a dramatic effect on the vote.
It resulted and Jenna being ejected.
What were your thoughts when you left here?
When we went back to camp, I was pretty much devastated. Everyone was around. We hung around by the campfire. And both the remaining Pagan people and the remaining Tagi people urged me, implored me to vote in my own best interest, to get with the program, in the immortal words of Sue, to get some balls. And, you know, that's what I plan to do from here on out.
I'm going to try to put on some weight before I go home. Everyone's telling me I look ugly.
The food I miss, but not as much as my parents. The hardest part for me about being here is that I miss my family, and Like I've reiterated 1,000 times over, I'm no mama's boy, but I really like to see my family. They mean an enormous amount to me. But when you think of their smiles and their hugs and stuff like that, I just can't wait to see them.
They'll be gunning for us if they're not already. I think they are.
Comes a point where you have to turn code a little bit, be a little more strategic, a little more self-preservative. It's a serious contest. There's a lot of money at stake, and I better start treating it that way. No one's here just to make friends and shake hands and have relationships for the rest of the time.
Which of the following can you drink to kill intestinal parasites? A, distilled water. B, mango juice. C, kerosene. D, ginger ale. Both ready?
Yeah.
Richard, you really wanted that, didn't you?
Did I lose it?
Sean, congratulations. C, kerosene.
Oh, I thought that would kill you. Good job.
Sean, congratulations. That yacht right there is all yours. One night, hot shower, hot towels, and everything else we talked about. Way to go, man.
Okay, yesterday I won a challenge, an island trivia contest. The reward to the challenge was lucky for me is a night on this luxurious yacht. I understand there's gonna be food, I hope dessert, a warm shower, television, maybe a newspaper. But hopefully I get to bring some company with me. If I'm allowed one person, I owe Kelly a dinner, so she's coming with me. This is an ungodly type of rain that we're not used to in the States. You know, I've seen some heavy rain pours in New York City, but this is heavy, heavy rain. I mean, serious rain.
This is really horrible. Survival of the fittest. Who could stand under an umbrella in the rain the longest?
I can invite someone for breakfast. Who wants it?
Pick her.
Kelly, do you want that to be a meal?
Sean, it's your decision. Don't pound it off on me. Yeah, Sean, get some balls and make a decision.
Vicky, scrambled eggs.
See you in the morning, Hatch.
Look as bony as it feels.
So come on in and take the oars or whatever.
Hi. Captain?
Captain!
Hey, Dad! Oh my God! Holy Toledo!
My boy.
Oh, Pops, I love you. I
love you too, son.
Oh my God!
You look fantastic.
Oh my God! I can't believe you got my father here. Oh my God, Dad, you made my whole adventure. I cannot tell you how much more this is worth than $1 million to me. I can't
money, even money. Tell you.
I thought the reward ample enough to spend a night on a yacht, get a massage, shower, shave, and to see my father there. I mean, it was just a dream come true.
Yeah, literally.
I have so much to tell you guys. I am definitely getting...
Oh, you all right? You all right?
I got caught in the rope.
6 out of 6 boats tonight. The Pagan people fortunately picked up on that because they all came to me in unison. They said, I think Kelly's up to no good. And so it was very plastic, very see-through. And even her biggest advocate on this island, Sue, saw right through that.
So what made you change your mind at the last minute?
Rich provides food. You know, the women that
yeah,
I was blessed for on the island.
The fact that you said, Kelly, all right, I'm going to take you, but you can give it to Rich, so I don't know,
want.
It's in your hands.
No, let me tell you, I'll tell you
he
why.
Tried to and pawn she knows it off on
Rich
me.
Also gave us tons of food. He goes out every day fishing for 4 hours, comes back with something in his basket 9 out of 10 times, which
but
is really great for the tribe.
But
this is what I'm thinking. So.
A day
and
later.
No, what do you mean a day later? Not at all.
I'm voting for Colleen, even though she calls me Putz all the time. I know we're good friends, and I like her a lot. She's a cool girl. So I'm voting, changing her name to Cooling. And she's a really cool girl. Enjoyed her company. And I'll probably see her next vote in the jury.
You know, everyone's honky-dory and all friends, but they all come to me and they say bad things about Richard, or they say bad things about Rudy. And then they go to Rudy and they say bad things about me, and they go to Rich, they say bad things about Rudy and I.
Hopefully it'll be us.
This is the most conniving bunch of people I've ever met in my life. There's not an honest one in the bunch. Conniving, conniving, conniving. Things are falling apart here. Ratana Beach.
I have been wishing for home since the day I got here. I haven't been away from New York in this long ever. I miss my favorite restaurant. I miss the people at the restaurant. I miss my friends. I miss my family. You know, I miss all of those things.
Everybody was very pissy prior to the mud bath, myself included. I mean, things really changed here today. There was a fight for the first time between Kelly and Sue. But truthfully, this little shenanigan game at the mud bath thing really paid off, I think. And it did. It rejuvenated us. And I think it rekindled, you know, just like friendships and laughing.
All I'm thinking now is win. Do what I have to do.
Now I'm in it to win, you know, and to just be a nice guy and just do this, that, and the other thing and pack it in is wrong. So I gotta win.
I'm gonna have to win immunity, and I'm gonna have to finagle, and I'm gonna have to try to pick up a vibe on people if, you know, like right now Sue and Kelly aren't getting along. Might be something I can exploit to my advantage. I might have to do stuff like that.
I'm winning this thing. You know, it's gonna be an uphill battle for me, but I'm winning this thing, the whole show.
I think largely that the next tribal council, there'll be, you know, a lot of votes cast in different directions that were never previously cast before.
I think the three people that are likely to vote for Sue are me, Richard, and potentially Rudy. Rudy's kind of swinging. Rudy wanted me whacked about 3 weeks ago. So, you know, he's a good guy. We sleep together, but he's ready to slit my throat in this contest any minute now.
At one point, whether it was happenstance or not, Pagong members were voted off one by one. Now they're sitting across from you, ready to say, now it's my turn. How's that sitting with you, Sean?
I'm sitting fine with me. I think the people that got to know me got to understand me and know where I'm coming from. But, you know, like I said, I conducted myself in a different manner than everybody, you know, unique. Was it smart? I don't know. I mean, it didn't make me feel good, absolutely. And, yeah, I mean, I'm very comfortable with them judging me.
I'm voting for Sue tonight, not for any particular reason. She's a good friend of mine and will always be a good friend of mine, but it's a self-preservation maneuver and needed to be done.
Sean, need to bring me your torch. Maybe the jungle is speaking to us.
Someone snuck up behind me, come on.
It went out during the vote.
No.
The tribe has spoken, the jungle has spoken. Okay. It's time for you to go. Goodbye.
I'd like to think I was the last good person down. I hope that's the way America remembers me. I conducted myself very well here. I mean, there are people I genuinely like on there, but there are some very callous, cold, and duplicitous people remaining in the contest. Good luck, guys. See you later, America. It's been a blast. Bye. The question, does the end justify the means? Apparently, these two contestants did whatever it took to get to the end. But, you know, it's not the end of the contest yet, in my opinion, because they haven't suffered all the ramifications of getting there yet.
Sean.
Hey, guys. Congratulations on being here. I don't have any questions. I spent 36 days with you on that beach, and damn it, there's a lot of things I want to forget rather than ask you questions about. I just have a few things to say, nothing disparaging about both of you. Kelly, thank you very much for being as capable as you are. You and Sue single-handedly kept that camp afloat. And Richard, dear Richard, also likewise enjoyed your company thoroughly. You played the game differently than I did, and it was contentious between us at times. And you're there and I'm over here, so go figure what I know. But either way, congratulations on being there. Thank you for teaching me a little bit about myself while I've been here. I think you've been very honest and constructive in any criticism you've given me. Your FNF idea, the fat naked fag idea, is extraordinarily funny, and fat naked fag with $1 million is even funnier. So I haven't made up my mind yet, but when I get back there, I'm gonna think about it, and we'll see which way it goes. All right, guys, congratulations.
Okay, guys, it's been a long time coming. It's been a long contest. The general sentiment in the jury box is that this contest has degenerated from a contest of who's the most deserving into a contest of who's least objectionable.
I feel that way very strongly. You both conducted yourselves in different manners than me, the way I would have wanted to. And you put the whole jury in a real difficult position. I don't think either of you truly deserve it, but I am voting for Rich because Kelly was clearly more deceptive, more manipulative, more double-faced than Richard, who's just an out-and-out scoundrel. But I like him in some bizarre manner, and I think that his fat naked fag idea is fantastic, and fat naked fag with $1 million is just hilarious.